Lab10, Kaminsky, Attack Lab. Last lab, we poisoned DNS cache locally. In this lab, we will poison DNS cache remotely. Some reference code. This code all revised from the seed book code can be used to generate DNS query, generate DNS reply, and so on. We may download those code again. This lab. Let's copy those code to this volume folder. You have seen this many times. Let's follow this lab manual to set up the environment, then we will launch the attack. It's similar to our previous labs. Attacker user local DNS server, attacker's name server. Here is just a simulation. However, in this lab, we will not use sniff and spoof as we did in the last lab, the local DNS cache poisoning attack. This one is a remote DNS cache poisoning attack. For simplicity, all these computers are connected to the same local area network. So we have three containers. This is the washing machine, the attacker. Build the images, bring up the containers. Okay, we have attacker name server, user local DNS server, and seed attack. So here's the seed attack, here's our container. Right, totally we have four containers. What I stated a moment ago is not, it's not a version. So let's open fork tabs. Then we follow this order. The tag user local DNS, the tag name server. Next one, user. Then the local DNS server. Attacker's name server. You have practiced all these commands many, many times since we are close to the end of this semester. Shared folder, volumes, host mode, or the attack machine. DNS configurations, local DNS server is simplified. The source port number for sending out DNS query is 33333. DNS attack is 12. Can use these two commands to dump the DNS cache or NDC dump db dash cache, and the cache file is under this folder where cache bind named as dump.db flush DNS cache and forward in the attack32.com zone. This forward zone you have seen in our last lab, so they are identical. Add to the local DNS server if anybody queries attack32.com domain, the query will be forwarded to this domain's name server, which is a host from the attacks container. Here, named.conf on the local DNS server. You can double check it here. Right, you can see there is a forward zone. The user machine, user container is already configured to use the local DNS, use this one as its local DNS server. So here it says the user container 10.9.0.5. User container here 10.9.0.5, and it's a primary DNS is set to be this DNS server, and it's a local DNS server. You may double check it here. Right, here's you'll see the name server. Attacker's name server. On the attacker's name server, two zones are hosted. One is the attack threshold, the other one is the fake example.com. So you can check it here. You see two zones are here, attack32.com and the fake example.com. Now you are asked to test the DNS setup. This is identical to what you did in our last lab, so it can be done quickly. Use dig command the local DNS server will forward the request to the attack name server to the forward zone if we dig this attack set2.com. So that's on the user's machine. Attack32.com. You see it's IP address. Attack32.153 here. This is the attacker's name server. Second test. Find the official name server for example.com. Again, on the user machine. Here you see the official IP address. And you see authority 0. So we didn't see the name server, but we get the official IP address. If you want to find its name server, and yes. For the example.com, answer 0 authority is 1 is the authority section. NS ICAN.org. So sometimes you run, you see some problems. Let's dig example.com for the name server. Here is what we get the name server for this domain, example.com domain. There are two name servers, IPv4, here IPv6. In this lab, we only use IPv4. 135, 133. And we have a fake answer from the attacker's name server, attacker32.com, for this example.com, here www. Then you see its IP address, fake IP address, 1.2.3.5. Once we successfully poison the local DNS server's cache, we should get this free cancer. all in one looks good. Now, for the attack tasks. The attacker will not send out question ask for this target FQTN. It will ask for some existed FQTN. Because currently this www.example.com and its main servers were cached on this local DNS server. So if the user asks for the IP address of this www.example.com, the answer will be gotten from its cache. So to trigger the server to send out queries to example.com's official names, we will ask some other FQTN in the same domain, example.com, but not in the cache. For example, on the textbook, we use some weird name, abcdef.example.com. For the IP address, or that abcdef.example.com, and the local DNS server checks the cache. There is no record. It will go through the root server.com server, then go to the example.com server, because we already have the www.example.com. So we have the answer for the root DNS server.com DNS server and the example.com server. So it will send out query directly to this example.com DNS server. For our fake FQTN, then we can flood some fake reply to the victim machine, as we discussed during the lecture. Here you can see a review image here. The existing FQTN TWYSW. Attacker sent to the victim DNS server. Meanwhile, spoof answers with this NS attack server.com in the authority section. Once it is succeeded, then the example.com's official name server will be in the cache, will be replaced with rns.attack.sato.com. After that, any FQTNs in this example.com domain sent out from the victim DNS server, it will all go to our attacker name server. Then we can give any fake IP address. Just a refresh. As we discussed, in the real world, both the NS reply ID, query ID, and the source number, source port number, they are 16-bit unsigned short. They are generated randomly to simply our task. The source port number is fixed to 33333, and just discussed the lab environment setup. In this both Scapy, Python, and C. Use Scapy and Python to create the quick query and the quick reply. Then we use the C language, C code to modify the packet and send out, as we discussed during the lecture. So please read this manual to refresh your memory. So the task overview. First, we will create construct DNS request. Then we spoof DNS reply. Then we use a C program to launch the Kaminsky attack. A framework of C code is provided. During the attack, we can keep check the cache of the local DNS server. If attack succeeded, you will see some record. I tried several times. Sometimes I got it quickly, sometimes I cannot get it. So it depends on your luck. How long can you get it done? Once we succeed, then you can verify its cache is pointed. Using this command, you will get the IP address 1.2.3.5, which is assigned by the attacker's name server. Okay, this is the overview. Now let's go through those attackers. The code framework provided may modify on this framework. I provide a reference solution to you. Those reference solutions are based on this code provided and the seed book code. Okay, now let's go through the attack tasks. Task 2, construct DNS request. We want random on the attacker container. Right here, the attack container. Go to the shared folder. Compare this attack.c. So we need to compare outside of the container. The container is very small. Many tools are not installed. Is compiled. So it generates a DNS query. The DNS query is sent from, because it's a fake DNS query, so it can be a random source IP. To a local DNS server, I want it to know its IP. From a random source port number to DNS port number. So you may change this source IP and the source port number to yours, what you like. Here we use a file characters, TWYSW. We fake in existence of QDN, this one. Then create a quality packet and save binary file. We also print out to have a look. We run in the attack machine. It looks like they're not executable. Generate DNS query .py. Permission denied. See, they're not executable. Let's make them executable. I may check it again. I will see if they are executable or not. Generate the query. This packet we generated DNS creation record. This DNS packet UDP and IP is saved in a binary file IP underscore rec.bin. Right, you see it's generated here. Can I use hex dump? You don't know how to hex dump in the container. You may use hex dump to have a look here. Can see, but it's not easy to see it like this. We may use a hex editor. We use hex editor to see it. Here you see the FQTN. With a hex editor, you can find the offset of this FQTN because we need the offset in our C code later. You may use a blast to open this packet. Suppress the output. Okay, here it is. You can see its location is hex number 29. So what's a hex number 29? You may use IPython, oops, Python 3, 0x39, or the decimal number is 41. Certainly, you may just use the hex number in your C code. This is how we construct the DNS request. You may use a Wireshark to see or to investigate this raw packet we saved in the file. How do you do that? You may follow this link where Wireshark imports hex dump. Now task 3, spoof the DNS reply. Here, you may use a Wireshark to capture the spoofed DNS reply. Certainly, you can use that Wireshark import hex dump raw packet. Here, you see the reference code is given based on the seed book code. Target name, target domain. Here for the true name servers of the example.com, you use this command, you will get these two IPv4 addresses. For the DNS reply packet, the C code will modify the source name or name the ID field. Here is the source. And the queue name name equals this token name, we will generate random file character names. Our name here is also in the reply answer section. We need to be identical as the question section, the token name. Here, this IP address, you may give any IP address. I'm to leave the most important part or the main goal of the attack. We want to poison the local DNS cache with this authority section. Attackset.com to save as the name server for the topic domain example.com. Again, we save this packet. First, let's generate it in the attack machine. Reply.py. Here you see the reply packet. IP underscore whisper dot bit is generated. Now we have two template packet. We will use them in our C code, attack.c. Here attack.c is based on the framework provided in the lab setup and the book code, seed book code. We open the IP request packet, then open the IP response packet, generate a file character random name. In a while loop, we will attack, keep attacking the victim local DNS server. We will print out the name and trans ID. Here, we only need to guess the transaction ID. We use a brute force to generate the transaction ID. Step 1, send out a DNS request to the target local DNS server to trigger the DNS server to send out DNS queries, because the FQDN does not exist. In the cache of the local DNS server. Both case will trigger the local DNS server to send out a DNS query. Now we will send the main spoofed response to the targeted local DNS server. Here, each name has sent out 500 times with a different transaction ID. The transaction ID keep loops through from 0 to 6 file, 3 file. And we have two official IP address, name server IP address for the example.com domain. So we will send out two response. Now you see how do we change the queue name. We need to find the offset as I demonstrated a moment ago. Here, change the queue name in the question section, in the answer section, and we also modify the transaction ID, then send out the DNS reply. Okay, currently on the local DNS server, the example.com is cached. Can find it like this. INDC. Dump DB. Here's the command. We use a dump command. Dump DB dash cache. So we can copy this one. Because we didn't launch the attack yet, so in the cache there is no attacker. We have an attack as attack site.com when we dig the this domain name, right? We verify it forward to the attack server machine on the user machine. So we have an entry. We also have an example entry. In this remote, there is poisoning attack. We don't need to flush. In our local DNS poisoning attack, the cache need to be flushed. Here you see lots of example.com. Here is the FQDN, the target FQDN. Here is the target domain, and see that information, the official name server. Once our attack succeeded, this should be replaced with our attack say tool. So we will keep check this attack, check the cache to see when this attacker is put into the cache as the name server for that example.com. And now let's launch the attack. As I discussed at the beginning of this lab, it depends on your luck. Go to the attacker. The attack machine. We launch attack. Keep attacking local DNS server. Now we check the cache. Still only have the previous one. If you see one more, we will succeed. No luck. If you're lucky, you may get it right away. If you're unlucky, it may maybe take you hours. I don't know. In this case, you may stop the attack and wait a moment, then continue. Start again and check the cache again. Still no luck. wait 2 minutes. Keep it attacking. Did you see the pattern or this ID number? Here 500, you may change it to 200, 300. On the book, it's 100. I will change it to 200 to have a look. Let's save it. Please pay attention, this modification does not matter. I just Wait, I don't want to wait to nothing. Want to attack again. Still no luck. If you try examples, you will see many atoms. Examples. Why I don't have examples.com? Stop the attacker here on the user machine. We dig this exam.com. Oh, is example, not examples. My bad. Example, we should have many items. Right here we have lots of them. And you see, actually, these are accepted. So it looks like our attack has succeeded. Yeah, the attack has stopped. So let's grab attacker. I still didn't see. These names are in the cache. Last one, JVIJL. Right, it's in the cache. So where the name server section, the authority section is not saved in the cache. the reply the assault section as the main goal. We want this part. On the user machine, we may have a check. Then we still have the official name server. The name server is still not it's not cached. So I think maybe I have some problems in my code here. CD, so the flaggers, we can check the meaning of the flaggers. RD recursion desired or a recursion available. AA associative answer. CD checking disabled. So what does that mean here? Yeah. I put something here. Recursion available. 0 not available. Or D, recursion desired. 0 not desired. CD, checking disabled. In case the variable should disable signature validation, that's not checked in the SAC records. Here, CD equals 1, not check it, but we don't have 0 rooms. By default, 1 should be disabled, 0 enabled for this meaning. Let's have a look what means 0, 1, or 0 means disabled, 1 means disabled. Recursive name servers. if the CDP is set, it indicates that the condition natural resolve is willing to perform port error authentication. It's a local policy request. So one means do the check. So we need to change to zero. Don't check anything. Connect, save it, and the OD bit. So how about OD bit? What does it mean? The CD bit is set. You need to check the recursive name, so short if possible. Okay, we also need to check all A, all D to set to 0 or 1. Save it. Here I just changed one bit the CD. You may check to see 0 or 1. What do they mean? Now on the attack machine, I need to generate the response reply packet again. Okay, now it's generated, then I launch the attack again. In this case, I want to flush. The cache, but I don't want to in this, as we discussed at the beginning of the lab, flushing the cache is not needed. Just for clarity, we want to see it with flushed cache. Now let's launch the attack. You may check example com or check attacker. Best way is check attacker. Okay, now you see attack succeeded. You see it here. It's an as name server or exam.com. So we can stop the attack. So it looks like that bit CD equals 0. Don't check anything. Now the name server becomes as attack.com for the example.com. We can check on the user machine. Before it's pointed, the local DNS server is pointed. The name server is the official real world name server. We check it again, it should be our attacker's name server. Right? It's not to become our attacker's name server. And so all the IP address for its FQTN will be controlled by the attacker's name server. You see it? 1.2.3.5. So our success, our attacks succeeded. You may try it again by digging that official example.com first. Then you launch the attack to see the official name server cached. Does not matter, but it depends on your luck when you will succeed. You may need to try many times. For that we can do it from here, or NDC flush, then on the user machine, you take this www.lambda.com, you will get its official IP address. Then you launch the attack. And check the cache, whether it's pointing or not. No luck. Still no luck. Now wait a moment. Okay, if you check example.com, there are some official records cached. Official records over there. Wait a moment, it looks like some of these are fake name characters. CCCF. No, it's not cached. Okay, that on your luck. Once you succeeded, what you will get is like this. You will get the answer controlled by the attacker's name server. Stop here, you may try by yourself to result verification. We want to see it, we succeeded once. You may wonder whether we flushed the cache will increase the possibility of our attack. You may have tried. Stop it. flush, launch the attack, check the cache. Still no luck, it depends. Okay, try by yourself, that's it.